You know, as you look around at all the things that are going on today, it's crazy out there, isn't it? You almost want to stay home. How many of you have been to the grocery store since all this has taken place? You work at Publix, don't you? I bet it's been crazy, ain't it?
Oh, yeah.
I've not ventured to the store yet. It's like really crazy. I mean, I have friends from Ohio sending pictures of shelves. Everything's gone. Everything's missing. Everything's sold. And I'm like, wow, I don't ever remember, in my systems of years, I don't ever remember anything like this. And I had a friend that shared, how many of you ever heard the song of the King is coming? Mm-hmm. Well, there's the one verse says, the marketplace is empty, no more traffic in the street. All their builders' tools are silent, no more time to harvest wheat. And it hit me like a ton of bricks. I thought to myself, I think we're getting there.
Yes.
I think we're getting there. And the Sunday school lesson that George preached this morning was about salvation. And man, you better be ready. Amen? You better be ready. Jesus is coming soon. So I'll just sing that. Trouble sometimes are here, filling men's hearts with fear. Freedom we all hold dear, now is at stake. Humbling our hearts to God, saved from the chastening rod. Seek the way pilgrims trod, Christians away. Jesus is coming soon, morning or night or noon, and he will be there. Trumpets will sound, and all of the dead shall rise, Christ seated in the sky, only where no one dies, heaven or hell. Troubles will soon be o'er, happy forevermore, when we live on that shore, free from all care. Rising up in the sky, telling this world goodbye. Homeward we then shall fly, glory to share. And Jesus is coming soon, morning or night or noon. Many will meet there too, trumpets will sound. And all of the dead shall rise, rising in the sky. Oh, we will go. Probably have a cage on my back, so that should be real interesting. But you know, God is in control about it, and I'm not worried about it. He's always taking care of me. He always has. He always will. And you know, he doesn't bring us so far in life and say, well, okay, I'm not going to do anything else for you. But he's not that way, is he? No, he's not. Some of you are older than me, just some of you. I'm looking for a song. I just felt like I needed to sing this morning. Just felt impressed to do it. But you can tell. I can look at you and know that God's brought you through a lot more years than He has me. And if He's done that for you, He'll do that for me.
Amen.
Aren't you glad He doesn't like somebody more than He likes somebody else?
Amen.
Aren't you glad that we're all His? And if you have a need this morning, I want you to listen to the words, because I've always felt like when I come here to minister, is that all we can get out of that one? Okay, thank you. When I've always come here to minister, I've always felt this way.
When I walk through the door, I felt His presence. And I knew this was the place where love abounds. For this is the temple, Jehovah God abides here. We on holy ground. We are standing on holy ground. And I know that there are angels on on holy ground.
I like the second verse this morning.
In His presence there is joy beyond all measure. And at His feet, sweet peace of mind can still be found. And if you have a need, I know He has the answer. Just reach out and claim it, child. You on holy ground. We are standing on holy ground. And I know that there are angels all around. On holy ground, let us praise Jesus now. We are standing in His presence. We are standing.
In His presence, you and I have that privilege to be in His presence.
Amen.
He didn't have to do what He did. He didn't have to love us. But I'll tell you this morning, I'm so glad He does. I'm so thankful that I have a God I can feel this morning, a God that I know loves me, and a God that I know is here this morning that will meet every need that is represented in this room. You believe that today?
Amen.
Amen.